Hey everyone, John Chow here from JohnChow.com, and welcome to Driving with John Chow. Want to answer another reader email on today, so let me see, I got one here. Yeah, from Jeremy Mayo. Jeremy, thank you for the question. And Jeremy's question is, how does someone make money without blogging? I hate to write. I don't want to replace a job that I somewhat like with a business that I hate. So, great question, thank you very much. First of all, how can you make money from blogging? There are tons of ways. Blogging is just one way of making money online. It is not the only way, it's probably not even the best way. But if you don't like blogging, that's fine. First of all, just because you don't like to write does not mean you should not blog. You see, a blog is just a blog, but here's the key. It doesn't mean you have to actually write for the blog. You know, you can have someone else write for you. Like in my case, I write for my blog, but I also have three other writers who post content on the blog. And in fact, those three writers post most of the content these days. I do mostly videos, right? Because that's what I like. I enjoy doing videos. And there we go. That's another way. You don't want to blog, but you like doing videos, then post videos and instead of blogging, right? So you don't have to write. You can hire writers. You can have guest writers. And they're pretty cheap. They're not that expensive. It depends. It really depends. Depends on the experience of the writer, how well known they are, and their production value, that kind of stuff. But generally, you can have blog posts for as little as $250 per post to several $100 a post. Like, it really depends on the experience. Like, if you get you order a whole bunch of blog posts from a company in India, you might be getting like 100 posts for $2.50 each. But my writer is a little more experienced. I pay them more money because, you know, I want quality writing. I want unique blog posts, that kind of stuff. Like in my case, let's see, I got my writers, most of my writers that came from me, I personally knew them, or they came to me. They were readers of the blog, and they submitted guest posts to post for free. They submitted guest posts, and some of those guest posts were really, really good. And I figure, this person's really good. So I contacted them and said, hey, you want to write for me full time? And I'll just pay you instead of, you know, you giving me the blog post for free in exchange for a link back to your blog. Right? But that's for another topic. So that's the first way. Hire writers instead of you doing it yourself. Second way, you want to make money, if you like video, then do the videos, set up the YouTube channel, do the video stuff. If you don't want to do videos, and then you go, how can I make money online? I don't want to do videos, then basically, it's just like having a regular bricks and mortar business. As the owner, you can either be a hands-off owner and just delegate all the functions of the business to someone else. Like you're the CEO, that's your job. You're the CEO, or you know, you can be any one of those individuals that makes the business work. Like in my case, I'm the CEO. I'm also the producer. I'm also the content creator. I'm also the chief marketing strategist. I'm pretty much everything. But for the writing, I had delegated a lot of the writing to other people because I want to concentrate on what I do best. What I'm good at, right? So what are you good at? What are your strategies? Like, you say you don't want to write, but can you create marketing campaigns? Because if you can do that, then you work on that. Are you good in front of a camera? You can do that, right? But making money online is two things. You know, it's basically two things. Your job is to get traffic and then monetize that traffic. Blogging is one way to get traffic. Video is another way to get traffic. Facebook, social media, advertising, Google ads, Facebook ads, pay-per-click ads are all ways of getting traffic. Okay. So what is your strength? What are you good at? What part can you do? Do that part. For the part that you don't like or you're not good at, delegate that to someone who can do that for you. Okay. So I hope that helps you, and hope that provides some clarity, answers your question for you. Any more questions or comments, leave it down below. I will get to them. John Shell from JohnShell.com. Thank you very much for listening. Give me a thumbs up if you like that. Please like and share my video. And if you're brand new here, please subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell as well. See you guys next time.